If you're new to this channel, welcome. If you're not new, welcome back. Today we are going to start working on our new project, which is an e-commerce project. If you're not sure of what I'm talking about, I'm going to leave a link down in the description for the preview episode so you can get kind of a feel for where we're going with this project and an idea of the different structures that we're using. In terms of stack, we're going to be using Laravel, obviously, and the version is going to be 8.6.8. We're going to be doing a default Laravel installation, which will include Inertia, Jetstream, and Fortify. Inertia will have Vue 3 baked into it, so that's the JavaScript that we're going to be using. Tailwind will be handling all of our styling. In terms of resources, I'm going to be using Mailtrap to handle our mail. It's handy, it's easy to use, and it's free, and those are three big winners in my book. For a search, we're going to be using Algolia. Algolia is a really sophisticated search tool that a lot of different web pages use, including Laravel, and I'll give you more examples of that once we get up to it, but that's what we're using for search. We're going to be using Laravel Cashier to handle the PHP portion of our payment system and Stripe on the front end of our payment system. So they're going to work cohesively together, which is going to be kind of fun because I haven't used Cashier before. For our PDFs, we're going to be using Laravel-Invoices, and this is a package that was created by Laravel Daily and his team. If you don't know, he's got a channel on YouTube and he gives you a bunch of tips and tricks all for Laravel and just different systems. It's a really good channel. But this project, him and his team built on top of a different project altogether and just kind of made it a little better. So that's what we're going to be using for PDF. For our shopping cart, we're going to be using Laravel Shopping Cart, and that will take care of all of our cart systems. So without further ado, let's get into it. Now I've gone ahead and whipped up a Laravel project already. All I did was run the command for it. I threw the jet flag on it so that we could get Jetstream and Inertia, and I've run it without teams, and that's where I am now. I also migrated my database already. I'm at the point where I have my welcome page already here. With the authentication built in, this is where we are. This is where we're starting from scratch. If you need to go ahead and do this, then pause the video, go ahead, do it, meet me back here. So what every e-commerce store needs is some kind of product. Let's go ahead and start working on that. I'm going to open up my terminal and I'm going to create a model. Product. And with this, we're going to need a migration. We're also going to need a seeder. Now that that's done, let's go ahead and start working on that table. First thing we're going to need is a name. The next thing we're gonna need is a slug. That's mainly for our URLs, so they'll all be unique for the products. Then we are gonna need some details on what the product is, and then we're also gonna wanna give a much more robust description of whatever the items are. And this, instead of a string, I'm going to put text. This will be a string. And for this, we're just going to create a simple product code. Next thing we're going to have is an image. Because I'm only using one image for these products, I am only going to create one system for it. If you were using multiple images, then you would probably want to look at some different relationships, probably some kind of polymorphic relationship in order to be able to handle those images for you. But for default, I'm going to include a default image. So in case something does not have an image, it'll have a fallback. The next thing will be table unsigned big integer. And for this, we're going to use the price. Now, people do this differently. I like to use integers for the price. It makes manipulating the numbers much more simple. So when you're doing decimals, you're doing percentages, you're doing anything like that, I tend to use integers. And even when you're using Stripe, Stripe has its own way of handling your prices. So the easier thing to do is just to leave it as an integer. You can do other things like decimal and just sort of try to manipulate it within the database, but I find this is much easier, a much cleaner way of doing it. The next one we're going to need is for quantity. Now we can go ahead and start putting these in our model. So I'll just select all of these, copy, go to the model, and then now we can add our fillable field. So protected. Now that those are sorted, let's go ahead and create a cedar. Or we've already created the cedar. Let's go ahead and fill it out. So down here, I'm just going to paste this in to make it go a little bit quicker. Going to import class, and then we'll go through what it is. So basically, it's just looping over between 1 and 12. It's increasing by 1. So that means we're going to have 12 items, 12 women's items. Their name is going to be associated with their number, which is why I'm concatenating the I here. For this, we're going to have women's hoodie. This is the description. We're going to just sort of fake a price for now and a product code. And the quantity, we're just going to do random between 1 and 10. The price is also random. So we can go ahead and do the same for men's as well. We'll just switch it up a bit. Okay, we can also do the same for kids. And we can also do the same for home goods. I think that's good for now. Why don't we go ahead and try to seed this into our database? Now let's check the database. We have our products in here. That didn't give us any products. That's because I need to actually put this cedar somewhere. So we'll put it in our database cedar. Then here we'll just do this call. So now let's go ahead and try to seed that. Okay, and we've got an error, column not found. Okay, so let's take a look. Product code, and then in the migration, product code, which means that that's also in the model, product code. Okay, let's try that again. Okay, so I need to remigrate. There we go. So now we should be good to go. Refresh this. So now we have our items. You see we have the name, the slug, the details, the description. Product code is 0 for now until we get the categories in. And we have our images, price, everything. Got everything. Fantastic. So now let's head into the text editor. I want to take this welcome page that we have here, and I'm going to extract it into its own controller instead of the routes file. Let's go ahead and open that up and get that started. Okay, so for here, let's go ahead and just make the controller. We'll just call it welcome controller. I'll make it resourceful, and we'll add the product model to it. We're going to eventually change this, but for now, this is good. Now we can go in here, and I'm just going to comment it, and then we'll say route. Yeah, the controller will be welcome controller. I'll just put index for now. As I said, we're going to be changing this, so name, welcome. Let's close out some of these. And let's go to this welcome controller, and in the index method, we're just going to return inertia render welcome. Okay, let's go take a look at that page, which is in our resources folder, JS, pages, welcome. Now, if you've seen the preview episode, you know that we are going to be changing all of this. So for now, all I want to do is to display our products and make sure that we're getting them. And a matter of fact, let me go to the welcome controller and make sure that we are bringing those in. Go back to the page. We can get rid of all of this styling. I'll leave this in here for now, even though we're not using it just yet, but we do need to bring in props. We already have a prop section. I'm just going to get rid of this one. And let's see what we're getting. So go back, refresh. Great, we are getting everything. I'm going to leave it there for now. Be sure to click the notifications and make sure you're getting all of them so that the next time I post, you guys will know immediately. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.